Bali is unique. A tiny island in the heart of Indonesia, the largest archipelago in the world, it has its own language, its own music, its own identity. In a country host to the world's biggest Muslim population, Bali has retained an essentially Hindu culture. The Balinese are deeply attached to their traditions, and the expressions of their culture count for some of the major attractions of this tropical paradise, along with the black sand beaches, the moss-covered temples, and the terraced rice paddies. However, visitors to Bali's luxury hotels and surfing beaches rarely see the other side of the coin, the problems caused by overpopulation, pollution, and a fragile economy. Despite the warmth of the Balinese hospitality, visitors rarely have the opportunity to participate in the daily life of the people. However, a dozen young Canadians have been invited to do just this in the village of Pengekosan, in the heart of Bali. And it is music that has brought them here. A Canadian composer, fascinated by the music of Bali, has written a new composition designed as a unique marriage of the traditions and cultures of both Western and Balinese music. The idea is appealing, but the challenge is daunting. Can these two traditions really meet?
I've composed a new work, and it calls for 35 or 36 musicians. 25 of them are a Balinese gamelan, which is a large ensemble of percussion instruments, mostly made of bronze, with lots of gongs and drums and flutes. And then I added into that an ensemble, a Western chamber ensemble, actually 9 players, piano, 2 saxophones, 2 clarinets, 2 trumpets, and 2 trombones. These are kinds of music that are very precise and composed. They don't have improvisation. You can't just put them together and say, here, play or jam on this. It has to be very carefully worked out. And so to bring those together, it's like microsurgery.
Michael Tenzer heads for Bali with 11 musicians, the winds, the brass, the piano, and 2 female members of the gamelan of the University of British Columbia. Francois Houle can play almost anything on his clarinet. But this is something new for him.
Michael me désigné leader, donc je m'attends comme leader plutôt à regarder un peu comment les choses se déroulent puis essayer de faciliter le processus plus que d'être un leader musical. Vu que c'est une musique que je connais pas, ben je vais arriver vraiment à me concentrer davantage pour justement montrer aux autres que même si on n'y connaît rien, on peut arriver à faire quelque chose avec.
François Lévesque is studying the trombone. He comes from a small town in Quebec and has never seen a gamelan.
Ben, je pense qu'on va habiter dans un petit village. On va vivre avec les gens du village. On va apprendre à les connaître comme dans leur culture. Puis il m'a dit on va être dans un hôtel, mais d'après moi, l'hôtel là-bas sera pas un hôtel comme on a en Amérique du Nord ou quelque chose comme ça. Fait, je sais pas trop encore. Ça va être à découvrir.
Leslie Tilley is writing a doctoral thesis on the music of Bali at the University of British Columbia. She speaks Bahasa Indonesia, a rare and invaluable asset for the group.
I walked into my advisor's room and he said, why don't you play in the Balinese gamelan? And I walked in on the first day, I remember so clearly. And we sat down and we started playing, and I hated it. I just thought, this is the most awful music I've ever played. How have I gotten myself into this for an entire year? And I don't know what happened after that, but Bali kind of gets under your skin.
The Çudamani group had a meeting before we came, and they decided amongst themselves that it would be better for us to rehearse in the late afternoon rather than in the evenings.
Çudamani is the name of the artist collective with whom Michael has developed a relationship over the years. Dewa Putu Brata is the leader of the group, which has acquired an international reputation.
Example Çudamani. Now already 9 years, we must play for apple ceremony than tourism. Yeah, we must focus on study with the old artists, teaching the kid and performing for the temple ceremony. In Çudamani, we have three groups for musicians. The adults now playing with Mikal, the teenager, the checker you show, and the youngest was the girl. And I think this was four group on the dancer. This group really like family. This because in my philosophy, the gamelan, the musician for the gamelan is need very close to the heart. Because work need like teamwork, like interlocking like that. Not just the technique we close, but also our heart. For me, that's my goal also for the teenager. Because now in Bali, so many modern things coming. I'm worried about that. And I catch them when they kid. Because I want to keep them traditional life.
So I'm going to put clarinets and woodwinds in between the pomade and the contrast. All right, it's going to be hard. We're going to try it that way. We'll see what we can do. And the trumpets and trombones behind the rail.
Rehearsals on day one. Time is short. The musicians have only 1 month to learn Michael's piece, written in a totally new style, and to perform it on stage at the Bali Arts Festival in Denpasar, the capital.
Something else anyway. So, okay, the B to C sharp is a problem, right?
I practiced it. What's your tempo?
As fast as possible.
Oh, yeah. That's perfect.
Okay. Let's...
And this.
But then, if we're going to go concert G, A, D.
Okay. Hey, Mama. Ring, ring, ring.
Yeah.
This is the village priest.
All the Balinese musicians do music for religion. They have a part of their music that's away from religion. But ask any of them, what's the source of your music? Religion. And what's it for? It's for religion. And if we took away our temples and our religious ceremonies, our music would die. That's what they'll all say. And so, before we have our first rehearsal, a priest is going to come and do offerings, and we're all going to be given holy water, and there's going to be incense, and this is probably going to happen every day in some way, sometimes bigger and sometimes smaller.
Centuries ago, Indian priests traveling to Bali brought with them the Hindu religion and its caste system. But the rituals in Bali are different and the caste system is less rigid. Priests belong to the highest caste, followed by the princes, the merchants, and the farmers. The young men of Çudamani belong to different castes according to their birth and the traditional occupation of their families. But when they are playing together, they are simply musicians, which brings them a certain status, but no salary.
Okay, so we'll start.
Are you ready?
I don't know how to do this, but what I'm going to try to do first is show them up to letter A. Okay? And this is going to take a few minutes. So, just listen.
Traditional gamelan music is learned by ear. The pomades in the first row memorize the principal melody, and then all the other instruments deduce their own part from it. But Michael's music is more than 20 minutes long and doesn't follow the rules of traditional Balinese music. Perhaps the learning process will have to be revised. The Canadian musicians have the advantage of the score, but Michael's music is very complex to read and difficult to play. Within a few minutes, however, the Balinese have mastered the first section as their colleagues watched, lost in admiration.
The gamelan musicians can't read music, can't we read Western music, so when they're learning something, I mean, this group is exceptionally quick. They'll just hear something once and immediately they know it. But if they hear something once and it was played vaguely wrong, or they assumed they knew where the beat was but it was in a different place, then it's really hard to unlearn that. So there's been a certain level of frustration in that, I think, on the part of the Balinese musicians, yes, but also on the part of the Western musicians, because then there's a lot of sitting and waiting while we relearn what we learned wrong the first time.
The instrument in the center is an ugal. The player is a kind of concertmaster and cues the group. The kemple marks the tempo.
So can we hear brass, winds, piano, complete?
One, two, ready, go.
The music is unfamiliar and the outcome is anyone's guess. Each musician plays with the utmost concentration, their eyes riveted on the music or on their neighbor's instrument.
Kalau pengalaman saya selama main musik, selain telinga sebagai penghubung apa yang kita lakukan, mata, setelah itu hati, senyum, itu merupakan unsur yang penting juga.
Yeah, okay.
Teknik, tampil itu unsur teknik.
The gamelan is a microcosm of Balinese society. Everyone has a role to play. Each musician is responsible for his part, which has to be learned by heart. And once that is done, there is no need to think. Playing becomes effortless. Each member of Çudamani is assigned certain chores. The members of the junior gamelan serve tea and refreshments during the rehearsals of the adult group. The Canadians are told to prepare for an important ceremony, the official blessing of the project. Everyone goes to the big market in the neighboring town of Ubud, and under Leslie's guidance, buys suitable clothes.
When you go to a temple ceremony, which we're doing tomorrow, we're getting blessed for the beginning of this project, you have to be properly dressed. So there's a pretty strict dress code. Everybody wears sarong, like what I'm wearing today, on the bottom, so just like a big wraparound piece of material for the bottom. And then the men wear this thing on top called a saput. You need to have a tie, and that's to separate the dirty half of your body, the bottom half, from the clean half, the top half. So that's why when you go into a temple anywhere, you always have to wear a sash. Even if you're just in shorts and a t-shirt, you put a sash on. On the top, men get to wear a nice, cool, cottony shirt.
Big. Large.
And women get to wear basically a bustier, like you'd wear for a wedding, with a lacy shirt called a kabaya. It's fun and crazy, but it's really great to dress people up. I love it.
One of the most important items of men's clothing is the udon, a piece of fabric carefully wound around the head. Balinese men wear these almost every day.
Balinese ritual calendar, there are 210 days. Once every 35 days, that means 35 times 6, so there's 6 different times in the 210 days, you have a day that's called tumpak. Each one of those tumpaks is devoted to offering or cleansing or purifying certain kinds of sacred objects. And today's tumpak is for all things made of metal, and that includes gamelan instruments. Most of what the priest does has an ancient history that goes back almost 2,000 years to when the first Hindu priests traveled from India throughout Southeast Asia. And the Sanskrit liturgy that they brought with them is still transmitted to this day, and the priests are responsible for maintaining that. And so he's chanting in Sanskrit right now, and that's not a language that anybody can understand here except priests. I think we're just going to be asked to pray, according to our, as they'll say, according to your own belief. We'll be asked to sit together and hold some flowers and, you know, and just meditate and concentrate on the flowers and the incense smoke.
I don't feel comfortable participating in the ceremony. I'm a Christian and strong believer, and don't feel comfortable in a different religion worshiping. It's a little awkward being the only one, but I'm going to stick to my beliefs. And I really respect the fact that their religion is a big part of their lives, but all the same, I choose not to participate in this.
Twice a day, certainly in the temples, but also in the houses, stores, and public places, priests or women carefully display offerings to the gods and burn incense while reciting prayers. The musicians stay in groups of 3 or 4 in guest houses located within 15 minutes' walk from the sangar. The music is more difficult to learn than they had anticipated. Between rehearsals, they undertake a strict regime of exercises and warm-ups.
C'est le plus difficile aujourd'hui. Pour les cuivres puis les vents, ça commence à être plus rythmique, plus d'interaction. Puis, vu que c'est pas vraiment de la musique qu'on a faite avant, faut qu'on s'adapte à ce genre de musique-là, je dirais.
You can play the gamelan for hours, but that's physically impossible for the brass.
La difficulté, c'est, je dirais, c'est la façon que Michael a composé la pièce pour les cuivres, pour la façon que c'est qu'on joue d'un bout à l'autre, les registres.
It's difficult for lip and mouth muscles to sustain long passages in very low or very high registers. But learning the music is not the only challenge the Canadians face. The accommodation is not what they expected.
C'est correct, c'est une chambre avec un lit, mais c'est rien de luxueux, pas du tout. Ça, c'est... C'est un peu sale, c'est pas propre, vraiment. Comme le lit, il est tout le temps comme un peu humide.
Ça, c'est ma chambre de bain. La douche est ici. J'ai enlevé la pomme de douche parce que ça coulait pas dans le fond. Et depuis ce matin, j'ai de l'eau chaude. Mais sinon, j'ai eu une semaine sans eau chaude. Fait que je devais aller dans l'autre bassin à côté. Puis comme vous voyez, ben ça coule. Il n'y a pas de rideau de douche. ça coule à terre sur le plancher. Puis ça sèche jamais tellement, parce que c'est super humide ici tout le temps. Ça reste tout le temps un peu... C'est une araignée qui était grosse de la même. Bon, la même.
It's so big.
What is it?
A cockroach. It's massive.
Because we have them here and they're fine. They're this big.
They're usually this big. This is okay. Yeah,
we made friends with the small ones, but this one is.
This one, I'm like, is it a leaf?
I was just talking with it.
Thank you. Bye.
Nicole first came to Bali 3 years ago.
You have certain expectations because of what you're used to in Canada. And of course, having been here before, we know that those expectations get shattered and then you just have to deal with it. If you couldn't deal with it, you couldn't stay here. If you couldn't squat, you couldn't go to the washroom. It's just a fact of life.
Rachel has never been in Bali before.
Yeah, no, it's been interesting. There's no shower, really, so that has been a challenge. The first few days, it was amusing, and then now I had no shower again today. It's probably, we've had 10 sleeps here, and I've had maybe 4 days where the shower was on when I wanted it. Let me
check. Sometimes I feel like the typical white person that just wants a certain level, a certain standard, and we suspect that that's the real standard and that's the way that the world should be, and we want everything to conform to us. And they certainly make efforts to conform to that, like having toilet paper in the washrooms. It's not necessarily the only way to do things.
I think my reactions on the first day were actually a little bit more calm, but then, you know, after 3 or 4 days, you sort of go, okay, it would be nice to have this accessible to me when I need it.
If you see it as an adventure, it's fun. If you see it as an ordeal, you're gonna hate it.
Oh, yeah.
The music is a good chunk of it, but being in Bali is the other good chunk of it, and putting those two things together. If you're not enjoying either one, why are we here? So I want to enjoy everything.
Kecak is a traditional Balinese dance performed by young men and often called the monkey dance.
Welcome to gamelan boot camp.
Oh, yeah.
Tonight, while the brass players are having a head shaving party, all members of the gamelan are rehearsing a new version of Kecak under Dewa Putu Brata's direction.
My girlfriend's gonna break up with me now.
The Kecak is one of the best known Balinese dances. Nowadays, it's performed for the tourists, but initially, it was a sacred dance. According to the legend, the Kecak originated in the village of Blabatu when the inhabitants were struck by a terrible epidemic. The chief of the village gathered everyone into the temple to pray in order to banish the evil. First, the young girls entered in a trance-like state, and then the young men started to dance and chant. That is how the Kecak was born.
Tuck, tuck, tuck.
C'est intéressant à lire les visages quand on travaille parce qu'on peut voir que, en regardant les Balinais, ils sont très relax. Quand ils font des erreurs, ils sourient ou ils rigolent ou ils se taquinent un peu, puis ils repartent et ils se remettent à travailler. C'est assez intéressant. Tandis que quand je regarde les cuivres qui essaient de jouer leur partition, ben, tu vois qu'il y a une tension, ils sont tendus, ils veulent bien faire, mais il y a un stress. L'attitude est complètement différente. Très rafraîchissant. Je sais pas comment est-ce qu'on pourrait changer ça dans notre culture. Même en jouant dans l'orchestre, il y a toujours une attitude de soliste qui est présente. Même si tu joues un poste de deuxième clarinette, tu demeures soliste parce que ta partition, elle est unique. Et moi, en tout cas, ce qui me fascine, c'est d'essayer de trouver une façon de travailler où je peux être le soliste, je peux être le virtuose, blablabla. Mais sans perdre contact, un contact humain avec qui je travaille. C'est ce qui est le plus difficile. Puis il y en a qui le font avec tellement de grâce, avec tellement de joie, puis que ça en est contagieux.
You need to be relaxed when you drive in Bali. The roads are narrow, there are motorbikes and minivans coming from everywhere, and practically no traffic lights. Nevertheless, the group is happy to go to Blabatu to visit a gamelan factory. Michael is planning to take delivery of instruments he's ordered that will complete the university's gamelan. Although each village in Bali has at least one gamelan, and often several, there are very few instrument factories. Because music is sacred, the profession is reserved for the members of one particular clan. And these members enjoy a unique status outside of the caste system of Balinese society. Each gamelan ensemble includes about 20 instruments, from large gongs to tiny cymbals, as well as five or six kinds of xylophones, each of which plays a particular role in the musical structure. They are all made on the same principle. The wood frames are carved and painted with care. Then the bronze plates are cast and placed on the frames fitted with resonators. Depending on their thickness, the plates will produce one of seven notes of the traditional Balinese musical scale. But there is a unique feature. The instruments are tuned in pairs. When the same note is played on both instruments of a pair, the pitch of each note must be just slightly distant from the other so that a sound oscillation is produced. It becomes, in some way, the voice of this particular gamelan. This concept is completely different from the perfect tuning expected from instruments in a Western orchestra.
That's well tuned. I mean,
all the gamelan instruments that we have in Vancouver have this design on the backside of the instrument is a story from the tantri stories, which are roughly equivalent to Aesop's fables in Bali. When I first started playing gamelan 30 years ago, this instrument was not, it's not like it didn't exist, but it wasn't popular to include it in the full gamelan. Now it's featured, actually, sometimes it gets little features of its own melodic lines, and it has a distinctive voice, and you can always hear it. And when I got my gamelan, that wasn't really happening yet, so I didn't include it, but over the years I've decided that I should add it in.
Some of the musicians buy instruments, such as cymbals and drums. Michael arranges for the piñatas to be sent to Vancouver. Only 10 days left before the concert. There are more and more rehearsals, but progress is slow. Even Michael worries about the final result.
Okay, so I think it's really great to do it that slow speed. Helps me to hear all the parts. So, can we do it again now?
I sincerely don't know the value of my music. I don't know whether that's because of my lack of skill as a composer. Sometimes I think it's that. Sometimes I think it's because of the idea of what I wanted to do, my concept was impossible.
No one has ever written music for this kind of ensemble.
Okay, wow. So that was just to give you an idea of the sound a little bit so that when I record again, we can do a before after for the positioning and also for the quality.
I need to hear it a few times, but everything seems really well balanced and present. The complete is too loud.
Yep.
And that's because he's right in the center.
Yeah.
And that's often been a problem at recording sessions.
Do you want to talk about phrasing and dynamics and things?
Yeah.
Well, we'll go to the table.
Okay.
So, let's just look at dynamics mostly.
Okay.
Like, we could play this pretty strong. Bum, 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 ba-da-da.
Yeah.
And then back off a little bit. So that we're not playing this, otherwise it sounds kind of military. But we'll play it more like a little gentler kind of phrasing, you know, like I would say almost like a mezzo forte. This is the, it's
pretty... C'est pas une pièce évidente, hein. C'est très dense, c'est une atmosphère très dense, il n'y a jamais de partie qui ressort plus que les autres, on entend juste... toute cette masse de son. Ça en est fatigant pour l'oreille, puis aussi pour les lèvres, pour les cuivres.
Hein. I don't know, but the thing is, if I take out the saxophones here, I'm going to lose some of the harmony. Let me think about this.
No, but you could bring him back here.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
Okay, great.
There's no way we can move over there, I guess. If we're facing that way, then we can't see.
What if try that. So, rayong tatap, brass kasana. Yeah, you guys stay here.
Michael rearranges the stage in order to solve the problems of balance. Because the volume produced by a gamelan is huge, the equivalent of a rock concert, it's not surprising that the musicians have trouble hearing each other. One of the most famous cultural traditions of Bali is the shadow puppet theater, the wayang kulit. On special days, a stage is erected in the village and everyone gathers to watch a play. It often lasts most of the night. Tonight, Michael and his group have hired the most famous dalang in the area. The dalang is the narrator and the puppeteer. Alone, he will act the parts of dozens of characters and produce sound effects, all accompanied by a small group of musicians. The puppets, carefully crafted from very thin leather, represent the traditional characters of the Ramayana story. As usual, the dalang adapts his play to the specific circumstances. Because there are visitors today, part of the dialogue between Twalen and his son Merda is in English.
Yes, my son. If I die here in the heaven, I will be happy. Sure, happy. I'm tired, son. Live in the world is very, very difficult.
Why?
Why? Always busy with ceremony, you know that? Every day, every second, always busy with the ceremony. When the bomb, what bomb? We make a big ceremony, and an earthquake, we make another ceremony, very huge ceremony. I think that ceremony is not make, what's called that, not effect for the save the world. Don't say that, Dad. Ceremony is important.
On their way home, the musicians have to brave stray dogs that roam in packs at night. The dogs can be fairly vicious.
J'ai pas peur des chiens normalement, mais eux autres, ils ont l'air dangereux.
This time, it's too much for them. Francois, Rachel, and Malcolm, who are staying far from the rehearsal site, decide to move.
I'm absolutely terrified of the dogs, and it's a challenge to walk home alone at night, that's for sure. The move will definitely relieve some of the stress that isn't really necessary for... You're already here, you're working, and you have enough going on, and you don't need the added stress of having to get back and forth to where you're staying. You know, going home should be a comfort, and I think it was becoming less of a comfort, and that's why a few of us have made that decision to move closer.
Their new hotel is more modern and nearer to the Sangar.
J'étais content au début, tu sais, quand je suis arrivé ici, bon, moi, c'est, OK. Tu sais, c'est un peu vivre comme les gens de Bali, tu sais. C'est correct pour quelques jours, mais après ça, c'est assez bon.
My original purpose for this meeting was to bring you all together and just to say, you know, we're sort of getting into the home stretch here, and we haven't had a chance to sit down as a group in a while and talk, and I know that lots of things have come up. And on the one hand, I want to say that I'm well aware that my planning for this trip was imperfect. And because you know me now, you know my relationship to this place, and frankly, my reluctance as a longtime Bali hand to do anything that separates me from the world of my buddies here. And I didn't stop to think that anybody else might feel differently, which I see as a mistake, and I do apologize for that. I kind of want to say one more time that all I've ever cared about is that we have a good experience together. And that's what I really want you to take out. I want everybody to go home thinking that you did this thing that, you know, nobody else will ever get to do, right? And hopefully it's going to be meaningful to you as musicians and as people. And that you'll always feel welcome to come back here, and you've got a huge circle of fantastic musician friends that will always welcome you the rest of your lives. You know, because these kinds of connections, this is not a professional connection, this is a human connection. And that's why I love it here.
Çudamani musicians has visited Canada. Sudi taught the gamelan for 1 year at the University of British Columbia. He didn't have too much trouble adapting to the rainy climate of the Canadian West Coast. Today, Sudi is hosting a buffet at his family home for the visitors. Known as the lawar, this meal is served only on special occasions. The men have spent hours finely chopping all the ingredients. While the women serve tea, the master performs the final preparation.
He's the one that we, in this village, is really good to make our. So I invite him to come here. It's like a salad. So in that flour, we will mix star fruit leaf with coconut, with spices.
Sudi started playing music at the age of 9. He became a musician against his father's wishes, even though his father was a singer himself and gave Sudi his first music lessons.
Je pense que ça ressemble un peu à la nourriture qu'on a mangé chez Michael quand il a fait le souper.
Mais sinon, c'est un goût différent parce que c'est moins fort. La première fois que j'ai mangé ça, c'était tellement épicé. Mais là, c'est beaucoup mieux. Peut-être que je suis habitué aussi à la nourriture d'ici. C'est beaucoup plus épaisse que ça.
In Bali, people live with their extended families. Sudi, his wife and son, live in the family compound where everyone has a role to play and resources are pooled. Musicians do not earn a living. When they play at the ceremonies in the temple or at family celebrations, they are given a little rice cake, the nasi bungush, as payment, and that's it. If the village needs a gamelan for a celebration, the group gets a small payment. Usually the money is used to repair the instruments or to buy new ones. As time passes, boredom, fatigue, and discomfort become bigger issues for all the musicians. They are trying to play a piece of music that can't be learned either by the traditional Balinese method or by reading a modern score.
The learning process has been difficult, maybe more so this time than last time, partially because of things like the steady beat. It's not necessarily even the fault of when Michael is teaching us, but just even things like when, for instance, on my instrument, the rayong, when the bottom person is given a pattern, the second person can figure out what their pattern is in traditional music. But in Michael's music, the patterns are different. So, you know, sometimes the second guy will assume he knows what his pattern is supposed to be, but in fact, it isn't right. And so I've actually resorted a couple of times to using a score to figure out what's going on, which I don't like doing when I learn gamelan. It just, A, seems wrong, and B, I hate relying on it because I'll just never memorize it. But the music is just so unlike other gamelan music that the guys have a really hard time with it, and so do I.
J'ai vraiment décidé de m'investir un peu plus avec mes commentaires et de prendre un peu plus de leadership, si tu veux. Je sais pas, je pense que ça a aidé les cuivres aussi à régler quelques problèmes, là, puis à Michael à comprendre qu'il n'y a pas juste la partition. Il y a aussi les gens derrière les instruments qu'il faut gérer. C'est difficile pour lui, mais j'apprécie beaucoup son travail parce que je l'ai déjà fait, d'être compositeur, de jouer dans la pièce, puis de gérer toutes les partitions, puis de s'assurer que tout le monde soit heureux, c'est pas évident.
We do our sfrazando, but then we have to listen to the tempo, slightly different tempo.
Yeah.
Okay. SS, we've got subito pianissimo on the third beat.
So you want to mute there?
I want to try some open to open and things like that.
Okay. You mean like wah-wah, or wah-wah, you actually
nothing too dramatic.
Oh, it'd be like pop, 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 pop.
Yeah.
You know? Oh, okay, cool.
It's work, but it's not, because the collaboration process is so interesting to be a part of. And I thought, you know, looking at the music way back, would I ever be able to get to that point? And I want to do my best at this. I really want this to come together, and I started working on it in Canada, and that expectation is absolutely there at all times, that it must be at the highest standard possible.
Between the long work sessions, the musicians usually eat together at one of the family restaurants called warungs near the Çudamani Sangar.
je pense que ça va bien. Moi, en tout cas, ce que j'aime bien à ce point-ci, c'est que tout le monde connaît leur partition. On aurait travaillé sur tous les petits problèmes, tout ça. Maintenant, on fait juste du raffinement.
Je pense que ça commence à aller mieux. J'ai eu comme une période d'une semaine, je dirais, que ça allait pas bien pour le trombone. Dans la partition, au début, c'était tout très grave. C'était pas très bien écrit pour un trombone ténor, je dirais. Fait que j'allais retravailler un peu, puis j'ai fait des tests. J'ai essayé de voir si ça marchait bien avec Rob, si ça marchait bien avec les autres musiciens du groupe. Il fallait que je m'adapte. C'est la première fois que j'avais des problèmes comme ça.
Only 2 days left, the music has finally taken shape. Michael and Dewa Putu invite the musicians to share their experiences.
We have a, like, sharing our feeling, yeah, the arts side and also personally.
Who's gonna start?
Ada dua perasaan di sini menurut saya. Kenapa? Kalau kami di Bali, biasanya untuk beat, kendang dan pukal yang dan kalau di barat kan tulisan kadang-kadang yang menyatukan mereka menurut saya. Perbedaan ini yang menurut saya
tadi saya dengar dari komentar orang yang mengajarkan musik tentang saya bahwa musik barat itu temponya tetap, sedangkan dalam garapan ini saya merasa temponya tidak tetap menurut saya.
Oh ya,
tidak stabil sama sekali karena begitu saya dengar kantilnya agak cepat, sedikit agak lambat, tapi kurang setuju saya.
Something that I am going to take away with me, and it's really, really important, is that I think learning music just by heart and not having seen a score, it leads to a wonderful feeling and really a great energy, and I hope that I can bring that to whatever music I do, even if I do have to read notes.
I think for myself personally, when I'm given a piece of music and I'm reading, and we're reading the music as it goes along, the focus for myself at least is that we're focused on the music on the page, and it's not as easy for us, for myself, to stay in tune with the rest of the ensembles. I think maybe at the beginning, we're more focused on the notes, and as now we know the piece as a whole, we're more able to adjust and fit as a group and really mesh together.
Ce qui était bien hier soir, c'est qu'on sentait qu'il y avait vraiment une unité assez spéciale. Les gens souriaient, il y a toutes sortes de petites blagues qui se sont créées à l'intérieur de la pièce. On se regarde en se souvenant de passages qui étaient très difficiles, qui ont causé beaucoup de tourments, qui maintenant sont... on passe à travers très facilement, mais on se regarde en clin d'œil en se disant « Ouais, ben ça, on l'a bien travaillé, ça, on est fiers de notre coup. » Donc on est prêt pour la première.
Mengambil tema Bu Kata, karya Michael Tenzer, Canada. The performers and composer feel that bringing this collaboration to life helps encourage a greater understanding between our cultures, a goal full of significance, meaning, and spiritual value. Dear guests, please welcome Bu Kata Instrument.
Great thing was being on the stage with this group of people. We've been together for a month, and there have been ups and downs, and there has been a lot of hard work. And you know, as we didn't know until tonight, really, that we could really play together.
Mm-hmm.
The Canadian musicians will never forget their Balinese experience, nor will they forget this music. They have learned it by heart.